This video is intended for researchers, particularly beginners, who are just starting to use ENDF data for nuclear physics applications. I hope that you have come here via Google after tearing your hair out looking at this beast of a document. This will highlight the important parts of the PDF so that you don't have to read through the entire ENDF102.pdf to understand what's an ENDF file. So what's an ENDF tape? An ENDF tape is literally a text file of numbers with exactly same length of character for each line in the whole file, so that the entire file has either 75 characters per line or 80 characters per line. It stores data about nuclear reactions. An ENDF file tries to translate all information we have about nuclear reactions into numbers, which is why it's hard to read. Everything except for MF equals 1 files, even nucleide names, have to be translated into digits. Decay products, reaction types, etc., which are all discrete categorical things, have to be translated into numerical digits as well. Therefore, it's very reader unfriendly, impossible to understand without a lookup table that translates these digits back into meaningful data. But that's the legacy left behind by Fortran programming that we have to live with. Here's a list of jargons which may be confusing, as they are different to our modern-day understanding of these words. A tape is a single file found in your file explorer. A material is a chunk of that file containing the information about one isotope. It's possible to have only one material per tape, in which case the tape stores information about one isotope only. The MAT, the MAT, is a four-digit ID for the isotope. Sometimes the material is a mixture of several isotopes, like GD0, CD0, B0, which are gadolinium-0, cadmium-0, and boron-0, etc., where the 0 denotes it's a mixture of isotopes weighted by the element's natural abundances. A file is a chunk of the MAT section that describes one type of the data about this material, specified by the MF number. This could be general information, which is MF equals 1, or decay data, which is MF equals 8, or covariance data, which is MF equals 30 plus, etc. See table 4 for the comprehensive list of MF numbers and their meanings. A section is a chunk of the file that describes one specific nuclear reaction, specified by an MT number. See Appendix B for the complete list of MT number to reaction lookup table. Another thing to mention is that the ISAP is a much more human-readable integer identifier for isotopes. It's very similar to the Z number in MCNP. Each line of an ENDF tape is formatted in exactly the same way. 6 columns of data plus 3 to 4 columns of metadata. The data columns each contain up to 10 digits padded in front with spaces up to 11 characters each. The remaining 9 characters of metadata at the end of the line denotes the MAT, MF, and MT numbers respectively. Note that there is no extra space in front of them to save space, making it hard to read. And then the optional 5 more characters can be used to denote the line number within each section. The line number is reset to 0 each time the MT number changes. The meaning of the 6 columns of data can be decoded using monospace font text in the ENDF102.pdf in the corresponding sections. Blue monospace font text means the Fortran code that can be used to read it, so it's only meaningful if you understand Fortran. Green monospace font text describes what data is stored in this ENDF record. There are 5 special lines that you have to recognize: the head, send, fend, mend, and tend records. They denote the start and end of section, file, material, and tape respectively. And that's all the basics you need to know in order to start using ENDF.